After tallying almost 1,500 yards receiving and 13 touchdowns while winning the Rookie Offensive Player of the Year, Eric Collins knew his sophomore season was only the beginning of his story. Eric would work on his craft all offseason long, even learning new skills to hopefully become the new best wide receiver in the league and crack his goal of 1,800 total yards on the season. With last season ending in a heartbreaking loss to the Rams in the wildcard round, we would finally get a chance to resume playing ball in our first game of the season against the Saints, and we would look to have a bounce back year. After all the hard work and grind to get where he is at now, Eric is finally ready to get back on the field and prove to everyone why he is the true wide receiver one in the NFL. After just blowing by everybody last year with just top-end speed, he wanted to show why he was one of the best route runners and his after-the-catch ability this season as well. After taking a bad sack on 1st and 10, Justin Fields would step back and just toss the ball on up to the safety, and we would already have a turnover on our first drive of the year. That wouldn't slow down Justin Fields at all, because on the second drive, he would continue to throw the ball downfield, and he would find us all the way down the sideline, and then on the next play, he would find our running back in the backfield who would break a tackle and get us inside the 5-yard line. Trying to avoid double teams, our coach would put us in motion a lot this game, and this would open up other players like DJ Moore that would put our first touchdown on the board. But on our next drive, Eric would make a signal over to Justin Fields telling him it was single press coverage and he'll know he'll win downfield, and that's exactly what would happen as we get a huge gain and we would later get chased down inside the 20. But the Saints defense would continue to press us on back-to-back plays, and we would teach them a lesson and tie this game on up at 14 apiece, and this would be our first touchdown of the year. Our coach would call us a gadget player in the second half of this game as he would motion us in for blocks and move us around a lot in the second half of this one, and this would help our other wide receivers get wide open. You could see all the work we put in with Justin Fields happen right here in this game as the timing was all over the place as we were making huge catches all across the middle. But right after we have that big gain, Justin Fields would throw a terrible ball and it would get intercepted, and with only 2 minutes and 30 seconds remaining, this does not look good at all. Luckily, our defense would get a stop and we would have another chance to go at least get a field goal and win this game, and we would have a huge catch that would get us inside the 10 immediately. The game in our hands, our coach would end up running the ball with no timeouts left, and after we would try to hurry it up to get a spike, the clock would run out, and this would be the biggest boneheaded loss in NFL history. After tallying 240 yards and even a touchdown, Eric Collins and the Bears would fall to 0-1, where they would be taking on the Packers, a division rival, in week number 2, while they look for their first win. A team that Eric always played very well against in his rookie season, he's looking to dominate once again against them in this game, as he would start off with a huge contested catch over the middle. Every single game we played with Justin Fields, our chemistry got better and better as he would start throwing us more 50-50 balls down the sideline, and we would come down with it, and that would lead to an Ezekiel Elliott easy 1-yard touchdown. Our second drive wouldn't go according to plan as we would get jammed off the line, and Justin Fields thought we were running a streak, but we were supposed to run a comeback on this play, and he would end up throwing an interception, and they could take a 2-possession lead before half. Green Bay would phase Eric Collins all the way out the offense, all the way to the fourth quarter, where we only have 2 minutes and 50 seconds remaining to come back down from 17. But after failing to punch it in on a 3rd and 4, we would have a chance on a 4th and 4, and Eric Collins would drop it, and we would end up going on to lose our second game in a row to start off the season. With the season not starting how we wanted it to, Eric Collins would still put up abnormal numbers and improve individually, but would still look to help the team win in their next matchup against the Carolina Panthers. All Eric wants in this matchup is a win. That's all we want to walk away with. No stats, no nothing matters more than just a win in this moment, as we do not want to fall to 0-3. Sooner than later, these DBs are going to start to learn that you cannot press Eric, especially with Justin Fields and his chemistry. He's never going to miss a wide open throw. Our offense would come out on fire in this game as Justin Fields would find DJ Moore wide open on the sideline, and he would get his first touchdown of the game and get revenge against his former team. With Bryce Young looking like the best quarterback in the league as of late, we are looking to score on offense, but Justin Fields would throw an interception, and with nobody in the defender's line of sight, it looks like he's going to get a pick 6 and take the lead. This game was not going our way at all after the first drive, as Justin Fields would throw another interception, and it looks like this one is going to have a free run to the end zone once again, and they have 2 pick 6s in a row. This game was going absolutely terrible for us as Justin Fields could not hit a throw for his life this game, as he would have his 3rd interception in the first half of this game, but that would not be it, because on the next drive after they score a touchdown, he would force another ball to us, and now that is his 4th interception in 1 half. With the scoreboard looking absolutely terrible, getting blown out by over 28 points, Eric Collins would not back down as he would have a huge gain down the sideline, and that would later lead to him finding himself wide open for his first touchdown of the game, and we are trying to cut back into this lead. Even after that play, our coach would take us out of the game in the second half, and we would get blown out in this one. After falling now to 0-3 in the season, Matt Eberflus would send us a text over telling us to speak up in the locker room and turn this thing around. Eric would then get his team locked in as they would look to win their next matchup against the Baltimore Ravens. You wouldn't see much action until late in the first quarter, where we would receive a dink and dunk over the middle, but this would lead to the announcers telling us that we are on pace for 2,000 yards as we already have 467. After the first down reset, we're trying to connect on a play we've been throwing all season long, but this throw would be just untimed, and we would throw an interception to Marlon Humphrey. The interception wouldn't lead to any points, so that was definitely good for our defense. But on this next play of offense, we're going to break a tackle after the sideline throw, and we're showing how much strength we gained in the offseason. Justin Fields told us in the huddle that he saw they were playing a lot of cover two, and we would try to hit the sideline throw once again, and we would finally connect for a huge touchdown. With Lamar Jackson and the Ravens offense responding with a touchdown, we only have 35 seconds to go ahead and score, and Justin Fields would find us once again down the field and chuck up the ball, and we would come away with our second touchdown in the first half, and this is looking like Eric Collins' best start to a game ever. Knowing we were playing the Ravens, we knew we couldn't get too cocky, but Justin Fields and the offense were feeling themselves in this game. We are still trying to prove to the league that we are literally unguardable no matter who you want to put on us, and Justin Fields would give us another 50-50 ball chance, and we would come down with our third touchdown of the game, and this looks like our game to lose. Lamar Jackson and the Ravens offense would go ahead and tie this game on up at 21 apiece, but Justin Fields would chuck up the ball under pressure and throw an interception late in the fourth quarter, and with barely any time remaining, it almost felt like this one was a loss, but the Ravens defender would take it all the way for a touchdown, and we actually have a chance to tie it up. With only 59 seconds remaining and three timeouts left, we still have plenty of time to go ahead and tie the game on up, but Justin Fields is going to hit DJ Moore, and that's definitely going to help. After taking multiple deep shots, we only found ourselves with 10 seconds remaining, and Justin Fields would try to hit us on a touchdown grab, and he would barely miss us, and now we only have 6 seconds. The last play call of the game was just to give Eric Collins a one-on-one, and Justin Fields would do exactly that, and we would come on down with it, and our fourth touchdown of the game would tie it on up and get us to overtime. But unluckily, we would not get the ball first, and the Ravens would go on and score on their first possession, and we would go to 0-4 on the season, and this is looking like a disaster despite Eric Collins balling. Now sitting at 0-4, we knew the chances of making the playoffs were completely against us, as only one team has ever done it before, and we would be matching them against the reigning Super Bowl champions, the Kansas City Chiefs. Coming off our best game ever as an NFL professional, we had 4 touchdowns and 250 yards, but that did not matter as we were still sitting at 0-4. We need to turn up this game. Now we found ourselves in a 14-0 hole to Patrick Mahomes, and we needed to score ASAP, and Eric Collins would do everything he could as he had a big play on this one. But on the next play, we would check it down to our running back, and he would make a couple broken tackles, but then he would end up coughing up the rock, and we once again had loss of a possession. Luckily, our defense would hold them to 0 points off of the turnover, and we're just trying to get down the field once again, and Justin Fields would give us a big chance, and we would come down with it, and we're already back in the red zone. Struggling to put the ball in the end zone, we found ourselves in a 3rd and 15, and Justin Fields would take the check down, and we would try to make the extra block, but instead we would have to come off the field and settle for 3. This would be Eric Collins' worst NFL game yet, as those catches you saw in the first half were his only ones yet until the fourth quarter, until this big play happened, and we would be able to score and cut this lead down to only 7. But after Kansas City would score a field goal, we had to rush down the field, and Justin Fields would take a heave shot, and he would get the ball tipped and intercepted, and this game is just basically over. Now, after falling to 0-5, Eric Collins was becoming frustrated with how the Chicago Bears were playing and basically felt helpless with the rest of the season. Although our next game would be our easiest one yet, as we are taking on another 0-5 team in the Denver Broncos, and this should be a matchup we have a good chance to win. Our team started to play a lot better all around in this game as Bobby Tonyan found himself wide open, and we had a big gain to start off the opening drive. But after that big play to Bobby Tonyan, this drive would go to a standstill as we would have to chuck up a ball on 3rd and 10, and we wouldn't be able to get our feet in bounds. Our defense would get the ball back with 0 points still on the board, but Justin Fields would give the ball back right away, and this time it looks like they have a chance at pulling it all the way back for another pick six, and this would be his 3rd one thrown in the season. Our third drive wouldn't be much better either, as Justin Fields would take another bad throw, and it would get tipped up by the same player and picked by the same player, and he already has 2 interceptions on the game. Now trailing by 2 touchdowns, Justin Fields is going to try to look for us much more this drive, so there's not much more interceptions thrown, but that would not be the case on the second throw of this drive, as he would force it to us once again, and Patrick Surtain would come down with his 3rd interception. Now looking to make a play here in the 3rd quarter, we would get pressed, and you guys know how that goes when we get pressed. We win every single time, and Eric Collins would almost make it to the end zone, but get trapped down inside the 5, and our coach would pull us off, but luckily we would go on to score a touchdown. Now trailing by only 5 points, and with barely any seconds remaining in the 3rd quarter, Justin Fields would just heave the ball on up and let Eric Collins do the rest, as he would come down with it and have a huge touchdown, and we finally have the lead late in the game. We would also go for a 2-point conversion to tack on a 3-point lead, and we would easily convert that one as well. Now with the Broncos offense going ahead and scoring a touchdown, we needed to score one ourselves to go ahead and win this game, but Justin Fields would throw another interception, and man, this is rough. This game is basically over. Now down by 11 points with 20 seconds remaining, all we can do is get some garbage time yards, and Eric Collins would successfully do so as Justin Fields would heave it up, and he'd come down with a huge touchdown as we find ourselves falling to 0-6. We would basically need to win on out the rest of the season to make the playoffs, and we had another tough opponent as we would take on the Los Angeles Chargers, who only have 1 loss. Starting on offense, we wanted to put some quick points on the board and hopefully our defense would get a stop and we would have that timely throw that we've hit all season across the middle, but that would later lead to a forced read in the back of the end zone and JC Jackson would pick off Justin Fields. Our defense would give us great field position once again and we are looking to do the exact same play across the middle to set up a shot at the end zone, and just like the first drive, we saw deja vu as JC Jackson had a similar like interception. But on our next drive, we were able to get a revenge on JC Jackson as we would beat him down the edge and get another big catch to get us in the red zone. We're now trying to cap off that drive after that big catch, and we're going to be able to do so as Justin Fields would give us a chance over the middle, and we have our first touchdown to tie this game on up. It almost felt like Eric Collins was mad against JC Jackson as he got those two interceptions early. He's trying to get revenge on him as he would dominate him once again on a streak route, and that would get us inside the 15-yard line where we would be able to punch it in as our coach pulls us off the field. Now falling down by 3 points once again, teams are still not learning that you cannot press Eric Collins as he is the best line of scrimmage wide receiver in the league as he's going to have a huge 75-yard touchdown. After scoring 3 points in our defense getting us the ball back, all we had to do was take away all their timeouts and chew out the clock, and that's exactly what we would do. After falling to 0-6, we finally would get our first win in week 7, and we are finally starting to look like a better team all around, and we just need to capitalize on a couple more games. After losing so many games and fast-forwarding to the end of the season, we weren't able to make the playoffs as we only finished with 6 wins, but Eric Collins would smash his goal and end up with 1,900 total yards and 13 total touchdowns. Though we had a great season, we did not win Offensive Player of the Year, but we would secure a Pro Bowl spot, and Eric Collins would go on to win his first ever Pro Bowl MVP as he would end off the game with over 100 yards and even got himself a touchdown in the first half of this game. Although we had a bad season all around, if you made it this far in the video, make sure to hit that like and hit that subscribe. We have so many more RTGs on the way.